What's up, gang? Y'all already know we back with another one. So y'all go ahead and tune in. We most definitely finna hop into this Alexis Ware case, you guys. We gonna get into this video of her baby daddy, TJ. No, I do not trust him. I feel like he most definitely had something to do with this lady being missing, you guys. But we're gonna get into this video so y'all can kind of understand where I'm coming from and how I'm feeling.
Hold on, hold on, Dawson's.
You started?
Yeah. Tune in, tune in.
When you call King, tell King.
All right.
I'm just trying to understand, what was the smile for, you guys? Did y'all see that? Was that not a smile? Wait a second. I want y'all to see this. Was that not a smile? Y'all see that? No, y'all seen that. This nigga smiled.
Run it up. Tune in. I've been remaining calm too long, bro. Y'all got me messed up. Messed up, man.
It's the last for me. I don't understand, my guy. Your whole child's mother is missing. You ain't that damn hurt to where you, this shit just got you smiling and feeling good about yourself. Cause you waiting on your clout.
Messed up. Real talk. All right, check it. I don't know why everybody want. Oh, it's at 44.
Damn,
they wait. 45.
Do y'all see how excited this nigga is about how many views he's gaining on this? This is sad. This nigga is literally on here for clout. That's crazy.
Run it up.
Run it up.
I need 1K. Run it up.
Now he need the 1K, y'all. This nigga said, I need the 1K, run it up. And y'all see the smile on this smurf ass nigga face? Y'all got to know this man got something. Come on now. Like, he ain't showing no emotions or nothing.
All right, check it. Why y'all out there slandering my name, saying I'm a suspect, all this? I done heard everything in the brook, man. I'm talking about, y'all done nailed me to the cross. Y'all got me messed up, bro. I'm not one of them. But check it though. So, I'm going to run this thing all the way back before Lex went missing. You feel me? All right. For one, me and Lex been separated. You feel me? I left Lex. Lex didn't leave me. You feel me? So, boom. I left off and up there around about, October. You know what I'm saying? I ain't been out there, been back up there not one time. You feel me? Not one time.
So, we're going to make sure we go look at that Facebook page of Alexis where... Well, you so-called say you left from up there and stopped messing with her in October, which is a lie. But I'm going to continue. We got receipts for this, y'all.
So, boom, god dang on. Before Lex took this, her being missing, Lex was, I don't know, she was dealing with some kind of spiritual root shit. I don't know what was going on. She was just been talking outside her head, you know what I'm saying? So Tuesday night, 1:30 in the morning, she called me out. Wake me up, talking about some TJ. She say, "I know you sleep. I know you got to work in the morning." She say, "But let me tell you something right quick." I'm like, "What you talking about, Lit? What's up?" She talking about some well, my last 5 exes within the last 7 years they died. Huh? What you talking about? She said, "I wish death upon them." I said, "Bro, you is tripping."
So, y'all really think in y'all mind this girl called this man and told him that 5 of her exes have passed because she wished death upon them? If I'm not mistaken, she said 5. But why would she call you and say that to you? If you just said that you stopped dealing with her, you broke up with Lex, I left Lex, is basically what you just said. So if you broke up with her, why would she be calling you to let you know that her exes have died? And because she wished death upon them, why would she specifically call you and tell you that? Because from my understanding, the video from her other baby father, he didn't say Lex called him and said nothing like that. But anyways, we're going to continue.
You know what I'm saying? You need help, man. Get off my phone. You talking crazy. I hung up. She started sending me all type of pictures of a ladybug crawling on the ceiling, what the meanings of it, her Pisces sign, all type of weird talk. You know what I'm saying? So she fucking around later on in the week. She thinks she's, y'all seen all the posts that she was making.
Okay, and that's understandable. But if she sent you all of this, why these videos, not these videos, but why these text messages that you so-called say you received from her, why we have not seen them yet? We have not seen no messages whatsoever between you and Lex. I want to see those butterflies and all of that. I want to see these messages, TJ. Baby, you're going to have to come up with a better story than this because ain't nobody buying this. You trying to make it seem like this girl crazy and this, that, and third. She's sending you this, that, and third. Okay, baby, bring them receipts out. But we're going to get back to it.
She won the lottery, hit the lottery, and all type of shit. So she done spending that in Augusta that the lottery place with the kids in the car.
I'm positive right there too, also, y'all. Why would she be calling him to let him know that she won a lottery? You get what I'm saying? If they not together, what would be her reason for calling you? So I don't intentionally think that she called him. I think that he just seen that post on Facebook because everyone did say that Lex made a post on Facebook basically stating that she won the lottery. Or she thought she won the lottery. But I have heard this. So I think that's where he got that part from. Lex did not call him and tell him that, you guys. No.
All that. Yeah, they ain't telling all that. I'm going to keep that shit gutter, nigga. I'm tired of this shit. So.
And there's the smile again. There's the grin again, you guys. Pay attention. And you, how can you be keeping anything gutter with anybody when everybody already have seen that Lex post a lottery ticket like she had won? Everybody already knew that. Even her family knew that. So that's not something new that you could tell us that she intentionally called you. This girl didn't call you. You seen that on her post. That's where you got that from. She didn't call you and tell you nothing. Because from my understanding, from what her mother was saying, that she thought she won the lottery and she was giving everything up and she was going to move to Atlanta. So why would she tell you if she not even with you? But anyways, back to the story.
Boom. Come Saturday. You know what I'm saying? I ain't seen my son in 2 weeks. You know what I'm saying? Me and Les ain't been talking to none of that. You know what I'm saying? I ain't did none of that. So Saturday, come Saturday before she came missing, she called me. She was like, TJ, I'm down at my mama's house. She say, if you want to see him, you can come down. I'm like, okay, I'll come down there. Then she changed her mind saying that, nah, I just wait. Let me spend more time with him. I'm like, what you mean spend more time with him?
Okay, mind y'all, he said that Saturday before she came up missing, he did say that Lex was at her mother's house. And TJ stated that Lex said that he could come and see his child. And then she changed her mind and said, just allow her to spend more time with their son. Pay attention to the time frame, y'all.
You don't had him 2 weeks. I ain't seen my son. You ain't even let me video chat him. You know what I'm saying? So she's like, just let me spend more time. I can feel you crying through him. What you mean you can feel him crying through me? I mean, through him. So I'm like, hell? I said, okay, Liz. I said, can I get him Sunday, the next day? She was like, oh, let me think about it. I said, okay, I ain't going to argue with you. All right. Cool, get out the phone. So Sunday come, you know what I'm saying? This shit hurt my feelings so bad because at the end of the day, that's my child mother and I love her. You feel me? I know she been going through something mentally. I don't know what going on and that shit hurt me. So that's Sunday. I said, I called my cousin. I said, cool, you going to church? He was like, yeah. I said, man, I'm going to pull up. I'm going to church today. You know what I'm saying? So I pull up. I sat in the car. I ain't even get out the car. Man. I'm shedding tears because this shit hurt me. You know what I'm saying? I ain't never seen it like this.
From my understanding, okay, he said this comes Sunday, and he basically posted meet up with Lex or whatever. He said he go to church. He said he crying and all of this because he ain't never seen his baby mama like this. I still don't understand. First of all, he said she kept their child away from him for 2 weeks. And now that he want to get the child to spend time with him, she's willing to give him to him. So that really kind of don't make sense. I feel like he lying in between that also. I believe you've been seeing your child. Or if she haven't been letting him see his child, it was a reason. You get what I'm saying? It was a reason. It was something going on between y'all to where she would not let you see your child. Period.
So, you know, so I go to church. We go to church, leave church. Now, mind me now, before I went to church, Lex didn't even want me to go to church. She kept on saying, TJ, don't go to church. I keep seeing you dying in oncoming traffic, like a car gonna hit you head on. She saw me a car crash, which I got in my inbox. So,
and why would Lex be so worried about you dying if she just told your ass that she wished death upon her exes and they have died? You know what I'm saying? So why would she come out the blue and just tell you that after you already said that she told you that about her exes? Make it make sense now, TJ.
Somebody got killed on the head on a car crash. I'm like, Lex, man, listen. One thing about it, you can't stop death. You feel me? Like, whatever happened, gonna happen. I ain't scared of it. I ain't scared of death. You know?
Yeah, I heard he said, whatever gonna happen is what's gonna happen. So, nigga, you really referring it to her because you had something to do with her being kidnapped and you know it. But okay.
And we all gotta go. So,
Not y'all just heard this nigga say, we all gotta go. Why would make you say that to somebody? That just don't make y'all, that just don't click with me. I'm not finna sit here and be having a general conversation with somebody and let them know I ain't scared of death and saying to them, shit, we all gotta go one day. You know what I'm saying? What? That don't even sound right.
I went on to church anyway. She begged me not to go. I went on anyway. So we left church, came home, changed clothes, and went to the game and watched the NFC and the AFC game. Went to Wild Wings. You know what I'm saying? Watched the Kansas City game up there at Wild Wings. Left Wild Wings, went to my aunt's house. You feel me? She called me. And I put on speakerphone, let my cousin hear how she talking outside her head. So she got down, she been like,
Now, mind y'all, he said he left Wild Wings and went to the auntie house. And then that's when he received the call from Alexis. And remind you, he said he put it on speaker because she was talking out the side of her neck. So he wanted his cousin and them to hear how she was talking. So let's get back into it.
She said, where you at? I said, I'm at my aunt's house watching the game. So she was like, well, come and meet me on 29 at 7-Eleven where you get the kids. She said, I'm about to run out of gas. I got like 3 miles left.
So now he's saying Lex wanted him to come meet her on 79, and that she was about to run out of gas. It's basically what she said when she so-called called him. And he want her to meet, Lex want him to meet her at the 7-Eleven gas station.
I said, okay. So as she talking, she like, TJ, watch out for these cars. Watch out for a white car, gray car, black car. Now, mind me, now I'm like, okay, so I put on speakerphone, let my cousin and everybody hear him. So I'm like, okay, I'm on my way. So my cousin like, boy, go get you.
But my understanding, why would she be telling TJ to look out for these cars as if somebody is after TJ? That don't make no sense to me. You trying to make it seem like she trying to tell you that some people are after you. Basically, look out for this car, that car, all this crazy stuff with she see you passing away and all this stuff. That just don't make sense to me. It don't make sense to me. And then you want her to come meet you at the gas station for what? To come and get your kids? That don't sound right.
So I was like, shit, I say no more. I doubt no more. We left. I pull up at 7-Eleven. You know what I'm saying? She's sitting at the gas pump. I get out, go in the store. I pump 35 in her gas.
Okay, he said he pumped 35 with cash out. We're going to need to see that receipt too, TJ.
Gas tank, and I put 20 in mine. I come back out, get my son out the car. You know what I'm saying? She asked me, could Naomi go with me, her daughter? I was like, yeah, she can go. So I was like,
So he just went up to the car and got his son out the car, basically. To just come, go and get him out the car without asking or saying, is he going with me or nothing? Because he didn't ever mention that she wanted him to meet her at the gas station to get the kids, if y'all don't remember. She didn't ever say that. She just said she wanted him to meet her at the gas station. She about to run out of gas. Now, he done walked up to the car, and he done took the little boy out of the car, quote, unquote. And then he say, she asked, can Naomi come? And he say, yeah. Don't add up.
She said, okay. She said, TJ, watch out for this car. You see, you got pointing at cars, like white car, black car, gray car. She said, watch out for these cars. She said, matter of fact, don't stop at no red lights. So I'm like, man, what you mean? I said, babe, you need help. You need to get some help. So I'm like, she was like, she know, TJ, I'm telling you. She's like, give me a hug, hug me. So I hugged her, you know what I'm saying? The hug didn't feel right. Something wasn't right. So I got there and hugged, got in the car, and I pulled off. For y'all, the one that's in Anderson, I turn on Amity Road. As I pass Welfare Church, I barely pass Welfare Church. And she got dang on, she sped around me. Bus right going out of Anderson Belton Highway. So I just started calling. I'm like, where the hell is she going? She supposed to been following me to my mom's house. But she said she was going to her mama's house.
Bam. Y'all heard, he said he just lied. He said that she said she was following him to his mama house. Then he said, dang, she just said that she was, we're going to run it back.
For y'all, the one that's in Anderson, I turn on Amity Road. As I pass Welfare Church, I barely pass Welfare Church. And she got dang on, she sped around me. Bus right going out of Anderson Belton Highway. So I just started calling. I'm like, where the hell is she going? She supposed to been following me to my mom's house. But she said she was going to her mama's house.
See, he said that she said she was supposed to be going to her mama's house. But she said she was supposed to be following him to his mama's house. So what was she going, TJ? What was she supposed to be following you to? Because you just said she supposed to be following you to your mama's house. But then you switched it up and said she's supposed to be going to her mama's house. So it don't sound right. It do not add up, my guy. You're going to have to explain that piece. You're going to have to explain that, TJ. Because ain't nobody buying that bullshit. You're going to have to explain it.
So, I'm like, damn, what? That's what I called about 3 times. She cut the phone off. So, I go to the house. You feel me? I'm going to the house. So, goddamn, I call her mama. I'm like, man, you talk to Liz. She supposed to be coming out now. She was like, nah, I ain't talk to her. She said, so she like, I like, man, she got the phone off. I got the kids. You feel me? So, I'm like, she say, okay, I'm finna call her now. So, she started calling on Facebook, calling.
So, who he saying that he was talking to? His mama or Liz's mother? I'm guessing that he talked to Liz's mother.
Ain't get no response. We hear nothing else no more. I ain't hear nothing else. You feel me? So, all y'all motherfuckers like saying I'm the suspect. I wouldn't do nothing to my son's mother, to no woman, period. I'm not built like that. You feel me? Especially someone I'm love. Yeah, we weren't together, but that's somebody I love. You know what I'm saying? That's my son's mother. That's my only child mother. I can't goddamn do nothing to her. I'm on ankle monitor for one. I'm not built like that for two.
So, if you're on ankle monitor, why would you be out that time of night meeting up with her to get your kids just to go back to the house? If you're on an ankle monitor, you have a certain limit on where you can go and how far you can go. So, why would you be out at that time of night meeting up with Lex to get the kids? If you screaming that you on an ankle monitor, which makes me fail to believe that you're lying.
To kill no woman or do nothing, nobody, to be honest with you. So like, man, y'all kill me with all that. Why y'all is a suspect? Why y'all ain't got, they ain't gonna question him? Why they ain't question? I'm trapped everywhere I go. Everywhere I go, I'm trapped. A woman can't make me do nothing. It's too many out there. Don't get it twisted. I love Lex. Lex didn't leave me. I'm not no.
Well, if you didn't do it, then somebody else did. And that's a fact. Because you was the last person to see her, my nigga.
Tender dick. You feel me? No tender dick, nigga. I feel like I get any woman in the world.
Yeah, you feel like that because you had a bitch like her. Of course you're going to feel like you can get any woman in the world. But you're not that guy, sir.
So, like, all that. Just because y'all niggas like them obsessed with her and all that, I wasn't one.
Y'all heard what he said? Just because y'all obsessed with her, I'm not none of that. I'm not one of them. Nigga, you speaking on shit ain't nobody saying nothing about. So you must be obsessed with her. Who said anything about anybody being obsessed with her? You said that out your mouth. So are you obsessed with your baby mother? Because you know it ain't another woman like her? Because that's what it sound like. The fact that she probably left your ass. Because look at you. Just look at you, nigga. You ain't popping nothing. No, sir. No, ma'am.
Damn. I wasn't one of them. And all this old homosexual shit, all this HIV, all y'all straight. Y'all need to stop that, man. Stop that, man. Real talk. Stop.
And they ain't hit him with that one.
This shit, bro. Because I'm not one of them. I'm big on my character, my nigga. Two things I'll never be. A snitch and a fucking punk. Never, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Whatever lifestyle motherfucker got going on with the gay shit, that's their life. You know what I'm saying? I don't get down like that. So kill that shit, nigga. Kill that. Nigga, show some proof. I don't rock like that, bro. You know what I'm saying? So kill that. All this. And then, let's talk about these little YouTube channels and shit. Mm-hmm. Let's talk about her sister, Jazz. She talking about, we had a quote-unquote theory that she had been acting strange a week before. Like, we thought that her baby daddy gave her some bad drugs.
So why would her sister Jazz say that about you? What kind of drugs? Are we talking about weed here?
He sold drugs. Come on, man. Stop it. Stop it. And then you gonna tell these peoples why you and your sister went close? Come on, tell the truth. Why you and your sister went close? Don't blame it on me. You was fucking behind her. That's why y'all not close, nigga.
So okay, so who was jamming fucking behind Lex then? Tell us, TJ, since you missed the know-it-all.
You know what I'm saying? That's why y'all not close. So you fucking her ex behind her.
Cause she fucking her ex behind her sister back. So when did Lex have a chance to be with his ex? What year was they together? Or is you sure it wasn't somebody she cheated on your ass with? You sure that it wasn't somebody Lex cheated on you with? That her sister was probably fucking on? That's what it sound like.
Keep that shit a band, man. You know what I'm saying? And then what's so bad? I used to talk. I like, man, you and your sister need to be better than that. Man, y'all don't fall out about no nigga. She said, I tried. Her sister went at we.
But why would Lex be talking to you about her ex nigga that her sister fucked on behind her back? Why would she be talking to her so-called was dude? Why would she be talking to you about that? Ain't no female finna be talking to no man they fucking with about no ex that they sister going behind their back fucking on. Why would she come to you and tell you that? Why would you even be talking to her about that? You talking about that, you telling Lex that her and her sister shouldn't be beefing behind no nigga. That don't even sound right for you to even say that. You get what I'm saying? For you to even feel like you gonna check her about her sister fucking on somebody. You trying to make her be cool with her sister because of that. That don't even sound right, man. Go on with the bullshit.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, she the one that come around mess with Lex because you honked behind her, bro. You know what I'm saying? And Miss Alberta, me and you, we talk every day. Nigga, we sat on the phone nights crying, talking to each other every day. You know I wasn't no suspect off top, nigga. Let's keep this shit a band. Let's keep this shit a band. Like, yeah.
Damn, now he talks to her mama like that. Calling her, nigga, and everything. Oh, my God, you real disrespectful for that bit having your mother-in-law a while ago. You real disrespectful.
I'm here to tell when I was locked up during my time. What about that dude Lex was messing with, having a foul with?
So now it's coming out. So he basically saying when he was locked up, when he did that time, Lex was messing around with another married man. She was having an affair with him. While her baby daddy was locked up. So now you saying something about it. You must have felt some type of way. You been felt some type of way about that dude. You been known about this dude. But y'all ain't together though.
What about that? Ain't nobody speaking on that, is it? That's who was obsessed with her. Y'all seen the messages? She sent me the message.
Okay, DJ, then give us the receipts then. Like, we don't have time for you to be talking about no bull junk. And you ain't putting no receipts out there, sweetheart. And if Miss Operetta know too, Miss Operetta, come on now. Like, what's going on? Who is this man? Like, we need to know. Even though people don't want to put certain things out, like, it's good for people to know. That's the only way these people going to be able to solve this case. But we're going to finish this to this bitch-ass nigga TJ.
Tell me don't send it out. Don't send it out to nobody. Don't know. Nigga, I'm tired of motherfucker bashing my name. I'm sending everybody I know.
Okay, so send it to me then. You can go ahead and send it to my Instagram or my Facebook. Which one? How you like it? Send me the information. Send me the messages. So we can put it out there, TJ. Since you telling the honest truth.
You know what I'm saying? Come on, bro. She know whatever Lex had got going on, bro. If anybody know, she know. I ain't had nothing to do with nothing. Mm-hmm. Period. You know what I'm saying? I kept questioning, damn, Miss Alberta, was she talking to another dude? I mean, it gotta be. You know what I'm saying? Is this a plot, a setup, or something? What is it? You know what I'm saying? Like, what's going on?
So, Miss Alberta, do you remember him asking you that? Do you remember that? Because we got to get Miss Alberta on this show, period. We gotta get her side of the story.
So, I finally kept drilling her. So one day, last Monday, she sent me the message. She said, "Oh, it hit me like a lightning bolt." Mm-hmm. Yeah. She was messing. I didn't want to be the one to tell you. Yeah, she was having a foul with this dude. Come on, man.
Mm. Well, that might be true. If he's saying this, that her mother sent that, then hey, Miss Alberta should be able to back it up. You know what I'm saying? Then it's some shit that we don't know about. So we need to find out who is this guy that she's supposed to be having an affair with. Since TJ saying that Lex's mother sent him the message about her messing around with the dude. So who is this dude?
But y'all got there. But you already know what's going on. But you just not telling the police this shit. And here it is almost a month later. What type of shit that is, bro? What type of shit that is? Come on, man. Keep that shit a band, nigga. If I had anything to do with this shit, bro, them people that bitch snatched me, bro. I'm on an ankle monitor, bro. Stop bashing my damn name, bro. I ain't got nothing to do with nothing. Nothing, nigga. And I'm not on bond on no murder charge. I'm on bond on some shit I ain't had nothing to do with. Period. That's why I'm out. Yeah, true indeed. Let's, yeah, damn right. She helped me got them come on. You know what I'm saying? She put forth and work and get my lawyer. Don't get it twisted.
Of course, we know she did. We seen all that. Tell us something that we don't know, TJ.
Now, I had money. Them police put my money in their pocket. Don't get it twisted now. But yeah, true indeed. Yeah, she helped me get home. Yeah, she got them paid for the lawyer. And salute to her. I told her. If we don't work out, I will always have her back, no matter what. Never turn my back on her.
Because you'll never find another like her.
All these so-called friends she had and all this and that. Man, come on, man.
Okay, call them out then, TJ. That's your baby mother and you love her so much. Call them out. Who is the fake friends? Who is the so-called friends that she say that she had? Please let us know. Tune us. Enlighten us. Like, you trying to get justice for Lex. Like, put this shit out there. What you holding back for, nigga? You ain't no scary nigga like you say. Put it out there.
Lex didn't deal with nobody. She didn't even deal with her own family. My family was more of a family to her than anybody. And that's straight up honest truth.
Okay, so we got to ask Miss Alberta that also. Why didn't Lex deal with the family like that? Because TJ say Lex did not deal with the family. So that's another question that we putting out there to ask you guys. We not being scared in this case. If we want to solve this case, you guys, we got to get down and dirty. Not to be scared. Like, we got to ask real civilized questions.
And she'll tell you that. She'll tell you that. She ain't deal with her family. Where them kids went to every weekend? My house.
Okay, Miss Alberta did say that. They used to allow both of Lex's kids to go to the baby father's house. They did say that. So I can't vouch for me. So Bertha did say that.
If I was so much of a threat, a so-called woman beater, this gonna do something to her, why she bring them kids to me? She called me because she know they gonna be in safe hands.
I think the reason you say she brought them kids to you because everybody used to you getting them kids together. So it wouldn't look weird. So you would have people that's gonna back you up on it because they used to both of them kids coming over there to your mother house with you. So of course you gonna say that. Of course, because her mama can bag you up on it because they send both of them with you. Like, let's send both her kids with you. So, of course, that's something everybody know. That's not nothing major, sir. You got to tell us more than that.
She know they going to be taken care of. Yeah, she know that. That's why she bought them.
But why would she send them to... Why would she give the kids to you and not her mother? And call her mother and ask her mother to come and meet her and get the keys. It don't make no sense. Or why she didn't call your mother. I don't know. It just don't make no sense for you to say y'all not together. Y'all wasn't together.
Me. I wasn't the ex on that video account. I don't know who she talking about. The ex beating on her. Man, listen. I've been going off and up there since October. We ain't even getting to no altercation.
Okay, you say you ain't let you talk all the time then. So did she ever tell you that Sosa put his hands on her? I mean, you say y'all talked about everything. She called and told you all this stuff when this happened before she went missing. So she had to tell you that then, you say it ain't you.
Since I've been up though. Hell, she had access to everything. All my social media. Well, hell, I can't go nowhere. So what? She got to be talking about somebody else. Somebody else must have been up there. Damn sure with me.
But we're going to get the information from the neighbors because the neighbors did say something about the guy that was up here is what she said. So we're going to see who the guy was that she was talking about.
Feel me? So like, come on, man. Stop all that cap talk, man. I've been holding back, remaining humble, not saying shit because I know the truth and God know the truth. You know what I'm saying? Stop bashing my name, bro. Trying to kill my character. Y'all want me to cut up? I'm not going to cut up. I'm not going to leave my son. I ain't going to leave my family again. I done gave them people 9 years of my life. That shit old with. Exactly. That shit old with.
And Sosa, you ain't never took care of no Naomi, so stop acting and getting on Facebook, carrying on like you was this, that, and the third. Y'all all talk right about it's weird that he was there for Naomi, she would leave her child. Ever since TJ dealt with her, that was a package deal. Like, she...
What I told y'all, all of them know that he was willing to take Naomi also along with his son whenever his son came over to spend time with him. So this is something that the whole family know, from his side of the family all the way to Lex's side of the family. So of course that's something that he can throw in there and say that she brought him the kids. Of course he gonna say that.
She know us, like, she's a part of our family. Y'all seen her talking about crazy stuff.
I don't even care what they flip. Flip it. I mean, they been flipping the stories. I ain't care nothing about no flipping. You know what I'm saying? The truth is the truth. The truth is the truth.
Why her family that's so worried about her? Why y'all ain't been got her?
I'm about to get out, Tony. Yo. Yeah. But I'm...
Y'all heard her in the background talking about why her family so worried. Dang, but I thought y'all was all... cool though. Who is this girl in the background doing all that talking?
Saying though, hey, you hear me? Y'all stop all that cap, bro. Mix me with that bullshit. I'm gone.
Hey, I just want y'all to know he didn't come on here.
And that's the mother right there that I'm guessing. That's his mother.
To try to call out anybody's family or disrespect anybody's family, but too much has been said, too many false accusations, and y'all are you guys don't understand. We're losing sleep on our end as well. Y'all are posting pictures of a deceased grandmother, his grandmother, my mom's mom. That's too much. Y'all are taking our cousins and putting fake names behind mm-hmm. them. This is causing them to lose. It's causing drama in their lives. Mm-hmm. So for his jobs, TJ has lost a job because people out here making false accusations. Unless you got facts and you got...
Why would he lose a job because of false allegations? If he don't have anything to do with it, ma'am. Why would he lose his job off of hearsay if he don't have anything to do with it? I don't understand. Make it make sense.
Proof on what you're saying, keep it to yourself. It's wrong. And trust me, that if he had anything to do with it, they been came and got it. He is not best friends with no police officer in Anderson County or Greenville County.
Don't even deal with it.
They would have been came and got him. But it's too much. When I have to turn on Facebook and see people posting pictures talking about this is the same chair that my grandmother, that we don't even have with us no more. Y'all saying this is the same chair that he used to do some harm to her. When y'all say stuff like, oh, he ain't put up no search party. My own son was there on the first search party that TJ put together. And was had to go to the hospital because he was hurt.
I bet he was there. I wouldn't be surprised. But you know, the enemy always arises. And they always lurking. So, yeah, he probably did go searching, too. He probably hid some stuff, too. You got to watch snakes like that. Because person ain't going to be honest and let you know exactly everything. And just put it out there without no worries and no care. I don't know what to say about you.
Because they were out there in the cold trying to look for Lex. So, we've lost sleep. We prayed. All we want is for her to be brought home just like her family wants to be brought home. We have to look at Tucci.
If he didn't go look, he was going to be a suspect anyway.
TJ's son to say, dang, he needs his mama as well.
Facts.
Tell him, either.
Yeah, like, come on, man. And every search party, my partners, me and my partners in the woods. Why they sitting in the car?
Every search party, you and your partners in the woods. You and your partners in the woods.
I'm in the woods every day.
Every day. Literally. Y'all heard it. Every day.
Listen to these fake ass spiritual readers.
They
would. So you just listen to spiritual readers and all this going where they tell you to go. And your baby mama just ended up missing. So you ain't scared for your life. Oh, okay.
I'm telling me to go here, go there. I'm about lost my mind. I had to goddamn get back. Listen to these spiritual readers. Oh, her, she down there. She down there.
Okay, can you show us the proof of that? I want to see what spiritual readers told you this, then, and third. Because you got a whole lot to say, but you ain't got nothing to back it up, sir.
Telling my people, come on, let's go. We down now. Man, come on, man. I'm done with all that. I just hope God goddamn gonna wrap his arms around her and bring her home to the kids and to the family. Other than that, it's out my hand, bro. And fuck.
You see what I'm talking about? It's a joke to him. This is a joke to him. Like, you laughing, doing all this stuff to my son, man. If y'all, whatever he's about to say at the end, then you start like, what? Sir, I don't understand y'all folks. But, man, it's justice for Alexis Ware, man. Y'all, we trying our best to make sure we can do everything to bring this female back home to her kids, you guys. This is a very tragic situation for her family. And all I pray is for peace above her family. Y'all, do not forget to smash that like and subscribe button. Y'all already know we're going to keep coming back with these contents. Back to back, smash that like and subscribe button. Don't forget to leave that comment. And we out of here. It's the game.